this can explain you the trends that I mentioned about strategic marketing. You can also think of the trends in marketing also. I made a list of the traditional conventional situation and the present situation in the field of marketing. Go back to business environment, marketing environment, whatever changes that had happened there, as a consequence, marketing is influenced in its own way. Let me tell you first the traditional situation in the market and the present one. Traditionally, markets were considered as the place or the stage for the sellers. It was called the seller's market. Now, no longer it remains as the seller's market. The buyer is the king. Consumer sovereignty or the customer is the king. That's the concept today. Only those who can understand the customer, meet the requirements can survive, and others are forced to get out. So that the golden rule is, know your customer, please your customer, make your customer happy. The traditional market was a protected environment. There was something called license raj, restricted environment. Today, there are no restrictions in the marketplace. It is an open market. In an open market, you can remember the rule of the jungle, rule of forest. The rule of forest says survival of the fittest. If you are competent, you will survive. Otherwise, you will be made to go out. There is a lot of opportunity for people to grow. In an open market, anybody can grow. Presently, Indian industry has grown like anything. On the other day, you might have heard about the startups. Out of newly started startups, about 100 startup companies were about to become unicorn companies. I'm sure you might have heard of the word unicorn. Unicorn means companies that are doing a business of $1 billion, $1,000 billion. There are 100 startup companies which have reached the unicorn status. But at the same time, the problem is that they cannot retain that position longer because of the severe competition. And there is no guarantee that after 5 years, these companies are going to survive or stay, because it is an open environment. In the traditional situation in the marketplace, there were only few brands. Some 25 years back in India, there were not more than 3 brands of cars. But today, if you stand on any corner of the street, within 1 hour, you can find not less than 50 brands of cars, both domestic and international. Same is the case with any product. Too many brands means too much of competition. And the situation earlier was local competition. Only domestic companies, people who are known to me, were all fighting. But today, competition is global. However small your business is, you have to compete with the multinational players. That is the situation. For that, you have to equip yourself. And the competition was friendly earlier, because live and let live was the policy of business people earlier. But today, competition is cutthroat. People can go to any level, indulge in any type of activity. They can sabotage your business. They can get into any type of legal, illegal, unethical practices through cutthroat competition. More than anything, in the earlier business environment, customers were very patient. Whatever you give, they used to accept. As you are listening to me, whatever I say, you are listening, except a few. I can also hear one or two tunes with music. Okay, so that earlier, customers were very patient. Today, it is not the situation. Customers are highly demanding. Unless they get what they expect, they will not be with you. You need to understand this. Now, in order to cope up with the present situation, what type of strategies that we can make? I will just run through one or two. Gone are the days we were practicing mass marketing. Hope you know what is mass marketing. Mass marketing means one product for many customers. My company is capable of producing a single product. I will put it into the market. whoever likes to buy, let them buy. That was the approach. Now it is not the case. Now we are with the direct marketing, micro marketing, customized marketing, wherein you have to understand the requirements of the customer and produce one for the son, one for the father, one for the mother, one for the daughter, one for old, one for young, like that. Second, gone are the days we were considering marketing as a transaction. Transaction means I have a product, I will give it to you, you give me the price. No longer our relations will continue. But today, marketing is not just a transaction, it's a relationship building process. You cannot sell and forget. You cannot sell and escape. You have to take the responsibility. We are presently practicing something called a generations marketing. Generations marketing means selling products to several generations of a family, so that unless you maintain good loyalty and commitment with the customer, you cannot achieve this. Gone are the days, the objective of our strategies was to achieve customer satisfaction. Customer satisfaction is what everybody promises. You have to give them something more than satisfaction. What is that something more than satisfaction? That is called customer delightment. Customer delightment means giving the customer something that he has not expected, something that he has not anticipated. When you give such things, customer will be delighted. To do that, you have to think differently. Strategy thinking means getting into different field, relating it to different domain, making it different from what it is. I might have mentioned several times, don't go always on the beaten track. Get into the woods. When you are in the woods, you will find something new. So that anticipate, predict what the customer thinks and give him something unexpected that makes him more than happy. Earlier strategy that we were using was depending on the concept of USP. USP means unique selling proposition. Unique selling proposition means saying something great about me. I am the largest seller. I am the 100% Indian made company. I am a Indian. Something like that was the USP. But today, customer is not bothered about to knowing whether you have something special or not. Say for instance, for about 50 years, Bajaj company sold its two-wheelers by saying Amara Bajaj. I repeat, it's a very interesting advertisement that Bajaj has used for decades together just to say Bajaj is ours. Bajaj is ours. To make people to say that, they developed a message saying that Amara Asman, Amara Jameen, Amara Aaj, Amara Kal, Buland Bharat Ki Buland Tasveer, Amara Bajaj. The entire exercise is to say that Bajaj is ours, 100% made in India. If you say so, Amara Bajaj today, customer will ask a question, so what? How it is different to me? What I am going to get? Today, the concept is extra value proposition. Extra value means for every rupee the customer is spending, you have to give account. Tell him that in terms of mileage, tell him in terms of durability, tell him in terms of road grip. Don't simply say that I am Indian, I am yours, I am big, I am old. If I am experienced, 50 years old teacher, nobody bothers unless I add some value to it. Next one is, either to the strategy people was following was pushing the product somehow to the customer, either by convincing or by confusing. Today, if you do so, you cannot survive for long term. Instead of pushing the product, try to pull the customer by attracting them even from your competitor's shop. That can happen only when you think differently, you give something extra, you have to think in terms of that. Earlier the strategy was to think that if I give colorful advertisements, people will buy my product. That could be the reason many companies, both national and internet and multinational, were spending huge money on advertisement without bothering much about their product. they were under the impression that if we advertise on satellite channels with high frequency with a popular film star or sports star, we can sell more. But that day had gone. Today, people don't buy products just based on advertisements. Advertisement has become a piece of entertainment. What is required today is a sort of reliable, integrated marketing communication. That reliable, integrated marketing communication can happen only when your company try to keep in touch with the market and the customer through all possible means. Through all possible means, let it be through the internet, the mobile, the all possible media, both the print, electronic. In addition to that, public relations, public responsibility, social commitment. Through all possible means, how do you communicate? How do you present yourself in front of your customer that makes your entity? Therefore, this is the situation wherein you have to think in terms of holistically looking at the corporate, the company, the firm, not the department or the task. Marketing is everybody's job. Marketing cannot be done by only sales department or marketing department. As I told you, unless the engineers who design the product, unless the accountants who collect the revenue from these customers, or the logistics people who carry the product remembers that they are all surviving because of something of their image in the market, and it is because of the customer loyalty, no company can survive longer. Therefore, strategic management is a unified, comprehensive, integrated approach to develop marketing strategies that helps the company to achieve and sustain customers in a way better than that of its competitors. Because every company has to compete. No company is in monopoly today, even though if there is anybody who can claim that I am the only seller or the manufacturer, very shortly there will be a new entrant. So that in order to survive in the market, you need to develop strategies. As I told you, strategies are developed in the light of competition, challenge, crisis, confusion and conflicts. In that situation, how do you rise to the occasion? How do you think differently? How do you integrate everything related to your environment and surrounding, make a strategy to sell your product, not only to get the price for today, but to have a long-lasting relationship with the customer and make the customer to come again and again to my shop, my product and my brand. This is all about strategic marketing. In brief, if you have any queries now, you can interact.